Now at 11, Indianapolis will soon join the growing list of cities with major streets that carry the words Black Lives Matter. It's a sign of solidarity we've seen across the country since the death of George Floyd. Thanks for joining us here at 11 o'clock. I'm Mark Mullins. The future mural on Indiana Avenue is something local advocates have been working on for a while. RTV6's Cameron Riddle shows you why the location was intentionally chosen and what happens after the paint has dried.
Indiana Avenue will soon look a little different when the words Black Lives Matter are painted on this historic stretch of road, a once prominent area for black-owned businesses in the early days of Indianapolis.
Indiana Avenue historically was a black area where black people gathered that had bars and clubs and businesses that were dedicated to black people.
Somewhere near the Madam Walker Legacy Center and the headquarters for the Indianapolis Urban League will be a mural with the words Black Lives Matter along with the faces of people killed by police in Indianapolis. The plan was approved by the City County Council this week, but members of Indy 10 have been working on the concept and planning for several weeks.
We wanted to be a part of it specifically to make sure that it was brought down to a local level, that the names that were spoken weren't just George Floyd, weren't just Mike Brown, names that are very important, but it was also brought down to Christopher Goodlow, Dre John Reed, Mikhail Rose, you know, Eleanor Northington.
Members of Indy 10 say protesting in the streets isn't the only thing they do. Their goal is to show why Black Lives Matter and why there is a need for systemic change. You'll see them do that as they work to elevate black artists and performers from Indy, creating a paid opportunity for black artists to paint the mural and black performers who will be on stage at the block party for the mural's unveiling.
So this really is a way for us to center black joy and to make sure that we are sustaining our community as we're seeking to do it.
While the mural could be considered a step toward progress, members of Indy 10 Black Lives Matter say there is still plenty of work ahead.
Because we are getting a mural painted in the street does not mean that we stop fighting for justice, that we still have demands, we still need systemic change, we still need for the police to be defunded, and we still need the autopsy report for Dre John Reed to be released, and we need for the officers to be brought to justice.
In Indianapolis, Cameron Riddle, RTV6.
Indy 10 Black Lives Matter will host a block party as the last letters are painted on Indiana Avenue on Saturday, August 1st from 10 a.m. until 4 p.m. Guests of the block party will be asked to remain socially distant.